Hello, hello. I don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. I'm one of those people, like, I get a song cue in my head, right? I think I need to say hello, and all of a sudden I'm singing a song for no reason on earth. I don't know why I do this to myself. I need help, probably. Anyway, it's good to see you guys. I'm glad you could make it. Thank you so much for stopping by. Pull up a chair. We're going to go over V-tools, V-gouges, U-tools, U-gouges, skews, whatever you want to call them. We're going to go over all of those things outside of knives that you use to cut your wood. My goal here is to give you a good background on this, on these tools, so you can use that to make an informed decision. If you go to buy some tools yourself outside of knives, you can reference this, get a good idea of what you're looking for, and then you'll be able to go buy these things and make an informed decision when you're looking at the tool numbers on the website. Like, what does B/6/15/4 mean when you're looking at a file tool? What does any of this mean? We're going to go over it all today. And I'm going to assume that you didn't get out of high school yesterday, and I'll make sure I show you an example of what a 45 degree is, or a 90 degree is, or a 70 degree, or a 60 degree when we're going over these tools as well, because I didn't get out of high school yesterday either, and sometimes I get forgetful. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump into it. All right, first thing we're going to discuss is V-tools. Whatever side of the pond you're on, if you're in the United States or if you're in Europe, we're going to reference V-tools differently, right? In America, we reference V-tools mostly by the degree of the tool and then the width. And in Europe, they reference V-tools by a number that represents the degree of the V-tool and then the width. So let's talk about file tools first specifically. This is, if you looked it up on the site, is a 15-6. Now, on the tool itself, you can see it's got a number 15 and an arrow. When this tool was first being made, the German family that made file tools originally, I think it's Werner Zulauf, the owner engraved an arrow on each tool in order to honor the family crest. So that arrow that you see there, that's to represent the family crest. And you're going to see that on all of the Swiss-made file tools. The number 15 represents the degrees with which that angle is. And for file tools, a number 15 references a 45 degree angle. And so that right there is a 45 degree angle. And a 45 degree angle is half of a 90. And we know a 90 is just a right angle, and this is half of that, okay? It's a 45 degree tool. But they also make a number 12. And a number 12 is a 60 degree V. And when we compare the 45 and the 60, you'll see the 60 on the left here is a little bit wider, a little bit more open than the 45 is, all right? Now, these, both of these tools here are both 15s, but they're significantly different. What is the difference in these tools? The difference here is the width of the tool along the top. This is a 15-6. 15 for the sweep of the V, and 6 for 6 millimeters across. And this tool is a 15-2. 15 for the sweep of the V, and 2 for the width across. So if you're looking these two up on the website, you'll see this listed as a 15-6, and this one listed as a 15-2. Easy to find, easy to get a hold of. The same goes for these. This is, on the right here, we have a 12-4, and 12 represents the 60 degrees, and this is a 12 as well, which represents 60 degrees. So we got a 12-4 and a 12-1, and it's much smaller on the 1. Now, when you're using these, I can use this 12-1 to create some nice sharp lines, and I can curve it around, piloting this very easily, right? But the walls or the sides of it are very shallow compared to the number 4 V right here, which goes much deeper. Now, I can barely put this into the wood and still carve almost the exact same types of lines. But if I go deeper by pushing harder, I can get a deeper line. I can go through that same channel again and get even deeper and deeper. And that's the nice thing about using a wider tool, is that it allows you to go deeper and deeper. Now, if you look, this angle here is represented right here as well. It's just that you're getting more tool with the wider V-tool. That is nice. That's fantastic. And you can use this bigger tool to great effect at doing most of the things that the smaller one can. So why would you get the smaller one at all? In a lot of instances, for most folks, you might not need to. But the smaller one allows you to pilot it on intricate curves much more easily, much more fluidly, and so you can do more with it on delicate work. It's also, because it's smaller, it allows you to get into smaller places that you can't fit a wider, larger V-tool in, right? Let's say I'm looking to fit this into a small place for an eye. Could this big, bulky, beefy number 15-6 make it into that tiny hole? Maybe. If it can, you might be able to get it done. But I can make really delicate lines with this if I wanted to. I can make deeper, harder lines. But it is a large and unwieldy tool. So, something to think about when you're looking at V-tools is the size of it, what you're wanting, what you're trying to get out of it, what the application is going to be for the end product, right? So that's how you know the measurements for file V-tools. For American-style V-tools, and this one here is made by Stree, a company out of Ukraine. But when they sell it, they're selling it as a 60-degree V-tool and a quarter inch. So this one's a quarter inch, 60 degrees, and a quarter inch refers to the width. In America, most of the V-tools we get are referenced by the width in inches rather than in millimeters. So this is a flex cut V-tool, and it is a 70-degree V-tool that's a quarter inch wide, right? Much easier if you're American to learn things by the American standards. If you're European, you're probably very familiar with millimeters, and it's not going to hamper you the translation between them, right? But for a rough estimate, like an eighth inch is about 3 millimeter, half inch is about 12.7 millimeter, 1 inch is like a little over 25 millimeters, right? So in this instance, a quarter inch is about a 6, right? And this is a number 6. So you can see they're roughly close. So 45 degree quarter inch V tool. So the issue with flex cut that I don't like is this. The handles are terribly shaped for me. For my hand, a shape like this is much easier to grip. It feels better in the hand. It just, I can grip it like partially between two fingers when I'm carving this way. When I'm pushing, I feel like it's got more meat to what I'm gripping and I can push into things. With this one, it's oblong and it's hard to index properly and doesn't feel comfortable in the hand when I do index it. I don't like the flat steel that's been bent into shape. It works fine. It's a sharp tool. It maintains its edge well. It cuts very well. So when it comes to that, flex cut is fantastic. A lot of people continue to say that flex cuts are good tools all around, and I'm not going to argue with them. I just don't like the handles on this. I will tout flex cut knives all day long because I think they're great. I got my start with flex cut knives, and they worked really great for me. But I don't like the flex cut palm tools. So your mileage may vary. If you like them, that's fantastic. And if they work great for you, that's wonderful. I just don't really prefer them. That's all it is. There's nothing wrong with them per se. I just don't prefer them. So that's a little bit about V-tools, right? So we're going to set these V-tools aside for a little bit. Something else to note before I move on is the difference between block and line of cut, right? So with the file palm tools, they have two different styles, and you'll see in the overlay here. The B15-6, which is this, is the block, and the L12-4, which is this, is the line of cut. The B and the L refer to the style of handle, and you'll see there's a slight difference in these two. And it's hard to compare until you get them right next to each other. The one on the left is slightly bigger. That's the block style, the B. And the line of cut, the L, is slightly smaller. And you'll see that also in the shaft. Look at the size difference here. The blocks are a little bit beefier, a little bit heavier, and the line of cut, the L's, are a little bit smaller, a little bit more delicate, and yeah, that's the difference between the B and the L that you'll see on the tools. So if you see a B15/6, that's the block style, 15 for the scope or the degree of the angle, and 6 for the width. So that's the whole thing broken down. Now, when talking about gouges. And talking about sweeps, you see I've written numbers on the backs of these to help me reference things, right? The lower the number of a sweep, the smaller the sweep is, right? So the shallower it is, right? So on number 5, it's going to be a very shallow sweep. It's going to be very shallow indeed. And the higher number we get up here to a number 11, you're going to see a much steeper sweep. So you see that's almost like a U shape right there. Right? This is a very small 11. So this 11 is like an 11.1 or an 11.5, actually, I think it is. Yep, it's a 11/0.5. So on Files website, if you're looking this one up, it would be 11/0.5. This is an 11.1, and it's just a small bit bigger. Now, do I need both of these tools? Probably not. File makes so many tools that you might be thinking you need to get them all, but I want to tell you right now that you don't. It is hard to get Palm Tools and get into Palm Tools because you're going to see people giving you advice saying you don't need to get all of them, and they're absolutely correct. Try a few to see what you like, and that's absolutely correct. That's great advice. The problem is, if I don't have them, how can I try them to know if I like them? I can't just buy one or two at a time because I have no point of reference to determine what's going to be good enough for me, what I'm going to like, what I'm going to enjoy. I'm going to attempt to provide you in this video with some point of reference, as much of a point of reference as I can, to limit the amount of times where you buy, like I did here, two tools that are so similar that I don't even remember which one I grab when I grab an 11. They're so close to one another, it doesn't matter to me which one of these I grab, I'm going to get the same effect with them. They're too close in size for it to matter. You follow? So when it comes to 11s, I'm not too worried. Now these 9s are different enough. Both of these are number 9s, but one is a good bit wider. This number 9 here is a 2, and this number 9 here is a 5. So it's a number 2 and a 5, and it's a good bit different, right? They're still a very steep sweep, but they're wide enough, they're different enough in width that this one I might use for an eyelid, or for nostrils, or for laugh lines on a face. And this one I might use for a larger carving for the same things. Or I might use it to provide channels on a robe that I'm carving, or on, I don't know, anything else that might need a channel. Maybe the petals on a leaf, right? That wider one is wide enough that it provides a different enough cut that I enjoy having both of these. Now, these bands on here are done by me, and the numbers in the base here, those aren't there normally when you buy these tools. I put those on there for my own reference. I want to be able to know which tools I got, and when all the handles are exactly the same and you don't know which one's which, I want to be able to look at the handles when they're sitting in a bin and know exactly what I've got. So while they both say number 9 on them, the 2 marks tells me this is a smaller one, and the 1 mark tells me it's a larger one. And that's what I use to reference, so I know, oh, there's my big 9, and oh, there's my small 9, right? Easy and quick, and that helps me to more quickly get what I want when I want it. It's the same thing here for these 8s. Now these 8s, they're not much different than 9. I probably don't need to have both 8s and 9s. So what I do is the 8s or the 9s, one of these two sets will be in my go bag and the other one will be at home. I don't need both. And I didn't know that at first. I thought I probably would need an 8 and a 9. But they are so close. Like, there's the 9. And these 8s here, it's producing almost the same cut. It is not different enough for me to justify wanting to have both an 8 and a 9. Maybe when I increase my skill. But I think that that would have to be a significant increase for me to really matter to me, the difference between the 8 and the 9. So there's those. Now, when it comes to the 7s, they are getting significantly flatter, right? Because as we get lower in number, that sweep will flatten out more, okay? And so these are fantastic. My most used palm tool is probably this number 7. And this is a number 710, and this is a number 76. This number 76 I don't use as much. I could probably do without that tool. But this number 710 I use very often when I'm cleaning up areas on caricatures or on smaller carvings, and I want to get saw marks off, or I've got rough knife marks. I can use this to get in there and provide a little texture to that section, or to clean up those knife marks. So let's say I want to clean up those marks here. I can do this, and I'm not taking off much wood, so I'm not affecting the shape very much, but I was able to flatten out those terrible looking marks. And I can use it to provide a little bit of texture to clothing, to put some lines on a pair of blue jeans or on a robe, and so on and so forth. Right, to clean up that chatter on the outside of a brand new rough out that you just got, that might help you clean that up in an area where you don't want to take off too much wood, but you want to clean the chatter off before you start carving. You can use this tool to great effect, right? Now, I do have one number five here, and this number five is a three. So it's very thin, because that three refers to the width, and five refers to the sweep. But it's so thin that I really haven't found a use for it. It just barely takes things off. And I would say I probably use this more as a skew. So let's say that I'm carving, and I'll use this little gnome here as a for instance, right? And let's say that I haven't cleaned this guy up yet. So underneath his chin here, this looks terrible, right? It's dirty and it doesn't look great. If I can't get my knife blade in there to clean it up very well, this tool being so flat, I can use to get up in there and carve that section to smooth it out a little bit more easily than I could with a knife. So that looks a lot better now. So that's a great thing to have this tool for, and that's primarily how I use it, is doing things like that. And that kind of transitions me into talking about sweeps and skews, right? Skews are flat blades. And at first, I thought I wasn't going to need any. These are basically a number one, right? So this is a number one. And when it's on File's website, and you can hear me clicking in the background, I'm looking it up so I can speak with some intelligence while I'm doing this. This number one is a four, and this is a 1S number eight. The S stands for slant, right? So when you're carving and you're getting up in under something, you can use this knife to push up into there and then chip out. And I did not think I would use these tools very often, but you'd be amazed at how often you find a position that you could really use a tool like this versus a knife, and it can get you into an area that you didn't think you could get into with a knife, and all of a sudden you're cleaning up cuts that just look terrible that you were leaving before. So having skews like this, slanted ones and straight ones, is fantastic. I would definitely get another one of these too that was smaller and thinner. I think I'd make great use of it. If it was maybe a little bit smaller than this, I would use it. I would still use it. So I definitely enjoy those as well. I don't have any numbers written on these. I just leave them blank, and it's easier for me to identify them because they're blank. And again, this one, it just says one, and this one just says one. Both of them just have a number one because they're flat. There is no plane to them whatsoever. And because there's no plane, there's no sweep to it, it's a one. All right. Now, let's talk about more entry-level V-tools and gouges. These are my dockyard tools. And dockyard tools are American-made. They say 2mm U, made in USA. They're easily identifiable on what they are. Dockyard Tools USA. This block here is just a 4x4 that I cut, and I put some, after I drilled holes in them here, I put some cork in the bottom, so when you drop a tool in, you can see it bounces a little bit on that cork and doesn't damage the blades. Now, I've got some V tools by them, and this is a 3mm V and a 2mm V, and their V tools are all 90 degree V tools. Except for, I think, one on their site is a 70. So these are 90-degree V tools. And these tools are between $15 and $20, depending on where you get them. They are great for carving, for little characters, little stuff. If you're just wanting to get a V-tool to try to see if you like using it, this is probably a great option for you. This finger wrap I put on there to easily identify when they're in here which ones my V-tools are compared to my gouges. This is the 2mm V here, and it does just as well. Small little V-cuts. Pencil style handles that I like those pencil style handles because I'm usually using them and pushing them like a pencil. So often I'm drawing with them almost to put lines in there, and it's just it's fantastic. I do like their handles. So even though I normally like much thicker handles, when it comes to dockyard tools, I think they did pretty well. Another thing I like about the dockyard tools is even though they're small circular handles, and these are all their gouges, they're octagonal in shape. And so when you set it down on the table, it doesn't roll away if your table is slightly slanted, which is fantastic. So that octagon shape, I like that for that. So these are all of the gouges that I have from them. And they have more than this, but these are the ones I bought just to see what I would like. I've got the 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the 2mm, 3mm, 4mm, and 5. And they identify themselves very easily. 5mm U, 4mm U. And the other one here, 2mm V, right? Easy to tell which is which. So these gouges, probably the one that got the most use is the 5mm U. When I was doing smaller faces, I needed a U for putting in the nose or doing stuff like that. This one has done great work. It looks like it needed to be stropped, and I put it away without stropping it. The dockyard tools are great options. The 5mm, 4, 3, and 2. The 2 is much smaller and thinner, like I said. But it too does great work, easy to use. And if you're looking to try them for the first time or try some tools and you're not looking to spend as much, the dockyard tools are probably a great option for you. I do have one straight tool here, smaller, and I use this one a lot. This is where I discovered that, yep, I like skews as well, and having a flat blade works great in this. It says 2mm ST for straight, right? And SK, I believe, is what it has listed for a skew. So those are my dockyard tools. And even though I don't use them as much anymore, now that I have these larger file tools, I still keep them nearby. And yeah, I'm probably never gonna get rid of them. They're fantastic. So there's that. So those numbers for sweeps, right? Those still apply to all these other American tools as well. And you may have seen me using this number 3 from KCT, Krishek's Carving Tools, a lot in videos, right? I use it a lot to take saw marks off of a carving. It allows me to create large flat spaces pretty quick and easy. I can carve into and take large sections, flatten them out, and get carving marks off or get saw marks off. And it creates texture too that when I paint or when I apply wax can catch that wax and stain and provides facets that people can see on the carving when it's finished. And I really like that. Now this number 3 here, it cuts well and it holds an edge well. It's one of my favorite tools. That is sad to say because all of the other Krishek carving tools I've got a number 5, 11, 9, and 7. None of these hold an edge very well. I can sharpen them, I can hone them, I can start using them, and they lose their edge so quick it's sad. And I can't suggest them for that. While one tool here is just picture perfect. Absolutely love this tool. It's so great. I mean, I can't express it enough. I'm using this one every single day. And these ones I never touch. I would probably use them more often. This number 5, I really thought I was going to be using this all the time. But man, I just make a handful of cuts with it and I need to take it back to a honer or I need to sharpen it. It just gets so dull so quick and I can really push down into that blade and it does nothing. And I sharpened this here recently. It does nothing. It does not stay sharp. This one would cut the devil himself. And this one, I can get it to cut that good. and it just goes dull so quick, it is insane. So stay away from KCT, I guess. I don't know. Maybe I got a bad batch. I bought those from various sources, but like I said, this one was great for me. Now, not all V-tools are created equal either. This was a very cheap V-tool. I got it on sale from, I think, Treeline, right? And it didn't even have a brand, I think, but it's a 45-degree V, which makes it easy to strop because you can just strop it and, on the inside edge on the corner of your strop layer right down the leather like so, and you can clean up the inside edge, right? But once I sharpened this one up, it's a cheap tool, right? There's no maker's mark on it. It holds an edge so well for so long. It is absolutely fantastic. And this 45-degree V-tool enables you to create a wider channel. And with a V, you can just keep going deeper, keep going deeper, keep going deeper. I am digging a hole, basically, with this thing. And look at that hole I carved out, right? It's a fantastic tool for that. So just because the tool is expensive doesn't mean it's going to be great, right? The tool steel comes into play here, how it was tempered, how it was hardened. You may be able to hone up and sharpen. And you can see, like, I have used this on my honer, and I have gotten a lot of those bluing marks, this black stuff off there, and polished that edge up. And once I got it polished, it has stayed sharp really well. So don't judge a tool by its cover. Give it a shot, even cheap tools. So to cover things, when it comes to sweeps, the lower the number, the flatter the edge. A number one being completely flat, and a number 9, number 11 being much more U-shaped, right? So when it comes to file tools, you'll see those listed as like a 15-6 for a V tool. This is the 15-6. 15 for the angle of the V, and a 15 equivalates to a 45 degree, a 12 is a 60 degree. And then the width, of course, is the second number that you might see. And you can take a look at the overlay right there. When it comes to American tools, you're going to see just the degree. So when it comes to flex cut, they might list this one here as a 45 degree. They also make 70 degree. Then you'll see the width. This one's a quarter inch. You'll see eighth inch. Those are the numbers you're looking for. When it comes to these tools, I want to make sure I say this. You do not need all of these. You'll be able to figure out as you go which ones you do need, which ones you don't need. I would say that if you get 11s, don't get the next one down. Skip one and get the next one. So I got 9s, which are great. I use the 11s and I use the 9s. But I don't need to have the 8s, which I do have because I got some sets and it came with 8s. The benefit is that I can have 9s in the house here, and I can have the 8s in my tool bag that I use on the go, so when I take them with me, and I keep one set here and one set there. If I use the 9s, I definitely want to have the 7s, because I definitely make use of those too. So having the thinner one, I probably don't need as much. I like having the wider, I think it's an 8, let me see here. Yeah, this wider one is a 10, and this is a 6, number 7. So that number 10, of the file tools, this is probably my most used file tool, the number 7. And it is just, it's a lot like this number 3. I use it for cleaning up large areas. The sweeps are a little bit different. The number 7 is a bit more of a sweep than the 3, obviously. But I use it for the same effect, the same thing, at just a smaller area for cleaning up flat surfaces and putting a little texture to them. That's a great tool for doing that. Really, if you're looking to get your first tool outside of like a gouge and a V-tool, let's say you get a gouge and you get a number 9, like I suggest in another video, and you get a V-tool. If you're looking to get something else, I would suggest a number 710 or number 3 KCT 1-inch. This is a 1-inch blade here. Those are great options. I use these a lot, so that's something to think about. And that's all I have for you. I am so glad that you guys stopped by. I really am. Thank you so much for watching the video. Listen, if there was any kind of benefit to this video at all, if you enjoyed it at all, please like the video, subscribe to the channel, head over to Instagram, follow me there so we can stay in touch and I can see your carvings, you can see my carvings. And then, yeah, watch some other videos on the channel. I hope you guys have a great day. Enjoy your week and stay safe, folks. Bye.